got a great story here, Eamon Keane from the Indians, and we're going to tell you how the Indians came about. And Eamon, as we said, the casino, fabulous band, not pulling the crowds.
Starving.
Were you? Yeah, literally, well, not doing the business.
It came to a decision we had to make, whether we were going to break up or stay together. And we'd been together for so long, as friends, you know, school.
Yes.
Four of us were school together, you know. So
the solution was totally radical.
I'll tell you now.
Crazy solution.
It was amazing.
Yeah.
Amazing.
Yeah.
And the way things accidentally fall into place, we were so lucky, you know.
Before that, we mentioned at the very beginning Mick Jagger and people like that.
Mm.
And regardless of the fact that the casino had actually played with the Rolling Stones.
Yeah. Mm. They used our equipment.
They used your equipment. You played with Roy Orbison.
We did.
The Bee Gees.
Yeah. Oh, that was a great experience at the Bee Gees.
Yeah.
To experience the live strings, you know, 14. They brought the full orchestra with them, like, you know. Yeah. What happened was, whatever politically happened amongst them,
yeah,
Tom Doherty was no longer looking after the Cowboys.
Yes.
And I approached him about the casino, taking on the casino, because I knew we were in the same type of market as the Miami and Capital kind of thing. And he says, we'd be interested in the band, he says, but we've an idea here. And that was himself. Tony Bowen was the drummer with the Miami.
Yeah.
And Joe Turrell was the pianist with Miami. So he says, we have an idea. Don't know if he'd be interested. And you know Tom well from
Northern
Western. But anyway, he says, how would you think of forming a band called the Indians, or becoming the Indians? And I looked over to Shay. Shay was sitting in the chair beside me, and he was gone white at this stage. Fairly quickly, you know, drained.
Not the best complexion for an Indian.
Well, he just... And I'm still looking at Tom, waiting for him to laugh. I'm waiting for the joke, you know, the punchline.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
But that was it. That was the punchline.
Were you in shock still now? Or were you beginning to warm?
I was being slightly creative. I started thinking about what could be.
Right, yeah.
But I couldn't give an answer.
Yeah.
Because I couldn't say that for the rest of the fellas. It would either mean me going ahead and starting another band.
Yeah.
But I wasn't interested in that. So I said, I'll have to talk to the fellas. We went and we had a chat with the fellas at the rehearsal. I put it to them as he put it to me.
Yeah.
And again, silence. And I says, lads, I've had a night's thinking about this. I sleep, mostly sleeping. Yeah. I said, the other half, I said, was... But I said... I've given it a good bit of thought, and you know, it's fantastic, I says, the idea that's come up here.
Yes.
Because every band out there is dressed up in cowboy western gear.
Right.
I says, there is no band of Indians out there.
Yes.
We would be the only ones. Now, we'd have to dress up in the costumes. And I said, yes, that's just a name change we're talking about. We're not going to have to do it right if we do it at all.
You were beginning to visualise.
I could see the thing. I could see the thing coming. But I still didn't know now. In fairness, I can't say that I know all. I'm not, because I was as reluctant as they were, you know. But the thing is, I said, but I've been thinking about it. It's worth a go because we've nothing anyway.
Yeah, yes.
So if we want to stay together,
yes,
why don't we go for it? And Jeannie, I've got a... Unanimous, yes. But we decided anyway. So next move was, where do we get the clothes? What do we do? So they located Bearman's in London.
It's the costumers.
Yeah. They would do films and shows, all the big shows and all that.
Yeah.
So they arranged for us to go across. We went over, myself, Shay, Tony and Joe, and spoke to them, and they said they had stuff coming in from a spaghetti western.
Right.
So that's used on film. So we said, yeah, that sounds good, you know.
And this was 1970?
71.
71.
71, yeah. It's, yeah. Very early 71.
Yeah.
So anyway, the stuff came. They got stuff over from Bearman's in London. It arrived to us in the Olympic Ballroom in boxes. The lads brought them in, put the boxes down, opened them up, and of course, They got something put up to the fella. Next thing, the fellas were falling around the place, you know. Yeah. And with the funny part, we got over it. You know what I mean? Yeah. We got over the laughing and the joking and still kept going forward, you know. Yeah. Next thing, we had a gig down in Shannon Golden in Limerick. And very few turned up. Very few turned up.
Right.
But we went on stage anyway. At the end of the night, the reception was so good that we knew it was going to happen.
Right, yeah.
We knew, you know, it wasn't a matter of just a few claps around. These people loved it, wanted more.
What I found fascinating is that you all had names.
Yeah.
You weren't Damon anymore.
No.
You were Sitting Bull.
We decided, yeah, if we're going to do it, let's do it right. Yeah, no, I was Junior, by the way, you know, Sit Bull Junior.
Sitting Bull?
Well, you know, you couldn't very well be Sitting Bull.
Why not?
The poor fellow was gone.
Yeah. Okay. How did you get that name?
Just that was it. I talk Bull all the time, and that was it.
And Noel became?
Flaming Star, because he was an Elvis fan.
All right, yes, yes. That was amazing. I remember, I mean, talking about, everybody said the Indians have added a splash of colour. Remember that being on the paper?
Mm.
A splash of colour.
Yeah, yeah.
I mean, to an already very exciting place. Yeah. You became the biggest, at times you were definitely the biggest band in the country.
Yeah, I suppose we were, yeah. The period of the 70s there, that was it.
I mean, that must have played right into Shea O'Reilly's hands, because he loved country, didn't he?
Oh yeah, oh God, yeah.
So it wasn't a case of let's change just for the sake of
Shea. Shea would have been featured a lot with the band in our first album, even, you know.
Yeah, yeah.
And the songs that he did,
yeah,
still stay with the band to this day.
You still do them?
Oh yeah,
yeah.
Oh yeah, you have to.
And I know that there are two songs that you particularly like to do, and maybe we can get you to do them in memory of Shea.
Yeah, as a tribute. Yes, absolutely.
As a tribute,
I'd like to.
To Shea. Mm. One of the great things about the Indians is that you may have thought at the time it was a flash in the pan. It wasn't. It has continued on. For 40 years.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, I mean, we were saved by going to the UK, you know.
Yes.
And we created a niche over there.
Yes.
And it brings us over quite frequently.
And it's still hugely successful, isn't it?
Well, you see, you've got population over there, which it makes a hell of a difference, doesn't it?
Yes.
You know.
Yes.
I mean, in Ireland, we have 5 million.
Yes.
Over there, they have 70.
That's right.
Yeah. You know, so I mean, it's a much bigger cake.
Yes, I remember my late colleague was very proud of the Indians, Fran O'Toole, God rest him.
Yeah, he was great.
Because
guy.
He wrote some songs for you.
That's right, Shy Little Indian Girl.
Yes,
and You Can't Stop an Indian Dance.
Yes, I remember sitting in the van with Fran, and he was actually very proud of that. He told me, and he would sing it. In the van, you know. Yeah. Did you ever hear the Indians do my songs? You know?
Fran used to come to my house, you see, and we'd have the odd party there.
The odd one.
Brendan and Grace and Fran, both there in the same night, and Fran brought in the keyboard and all, you know.
Right.
And we had some great sing songs there, you know. He was so creative, the chap.
He was.
So creative. An awful loss. An awful pity.
Eamon, we'll do another song. Hopefully you'll do it for us as a tribute to Shea again.
Yes.
Because he obviously played a huge part in your life, and he was a great country fan.
Oh, yes.
And one of his favourite songs was The Lonesome Fugitive.
If I can remember the words.
We'll give it a go.
Okay.
Eamon Keane, again in tribute to his late great friend Shea O'Reilly, with The Lonesome Fugitive. Eamon
Thank
Keane,
you very much.
It was a great pleasure.
Thank you, Stephen.
Younger days, while Mama used to pray. outright.